Al-Thani Human Rights presents The Rule of Law and Anti-Corruption Center, ROLAC. What is ROLAC? The Rule of Law and Anti-Corruption Center, ROLAC, was established by Qatar's Attorney General in 2009. ROLAC was established to supposedly work in cooperation with the national, regional, and international institutions to enhance the rule of law, good governance, and to combat corruption, and is partnered with the United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime, UNODC. The controversial establishment that has been initiated with the hidden agenda concealed behind the support of United Nations and other institutions. Where is ROLAC located? In Geneva. Address initially was located at 221 Route de Ferney in Grand Saconnex, and in February 6, 2021, changed to CO Evershed Sutherland SA, Rue du Marché 20. Changed on the website, but still it is under previous address at the Commercial Registry, which conveniently enough is the Regal Council's address in Geneva. For some that may not know, CO is used an abbreviation as care of, means through someone or by way of someone, which means the physical address hasn't changed. It is just the business forwarding address that has been allocated to their legal counsel. The change of address came right after numerous media outlets indicated that the ROLAC office was sheltered in a property owned by the Attorney General in Geneva, which was a property purchased in 221 Route de Ferney for €3.321 million, registered under a company named GSG Immobilier SA in Geneva, created on October 26, 2015. After the truth was exposed, they have tried to cover it up by promptly changing the address, but the physical location is still the same. In Qatar, address, Palm Tower B, Al Dafna, West Bay, Doha, Qatar. Both locations were verified, and no active person on any address. No employees, no office, and no one answer to any emails. An organization that is void, just as its structure. Who manages this elusive organization? As per the Commercial Registry at the Canton of Geneva, the organization is managed by Ali Mohsen Ftais, member and president, and Abdel Mohsen Hamad Ftais, director. Who is director of ROLAC? Ali bin Ftais Al-Marri is the president and founder of the Rule of Law and Anti-Corruption Center. ROLAC established an office in Geneva in March 2017 in Grand Saconnex, a town in the canton of Geneva. Having never been better served than by his own, the General Secretariat is managed by another family member, Abdel Mohsen Hamad Ftais, 32, born in 1985, still a student at the Sorbonne. The brazenness never ends. The latter, located at Route de Ferney 221, was purchased by Al-Marri's family through GSG Immobilier SA in November 2015, another specially set up vehicle that banks at a Kuwaiti financial institution. The office tenant? ROLAC's Swiss branch. Who is president of ROLAC? Al-Marri quickly made a career out of his loyalty. He has no room for maneuver within the seraglio. The Al-Marri are not lucky enough to be part of the elite, explain French journalists Nicolas Beau and Jacques-Marie Bourget. At the palace's request, he is the one who judicially executes the troublemakers, prosecuting them for corruption. GSG Immobilier SA acquired on November 10, 2015, just a few days after its creation, a property located at 221 Route de Ferney in Grand Saconnex for 3.690 million Swiss francs or 3.321 million euros or 14.854 million dirhams. In other words, the premises of Geneva's Rule of Law and Anti-Corruption Center, ROLAC, belong to its chairman, Ali bin Ftais Al-Marri. The Qatari government official also owns property worth over 20 million euros, including his anti-corruption center ROLAC offices through a Swiss company. French media outlets have raised questions regarding properties acquired by Qatari's attorney general and chairman of Rule of Law and Anti-Corruption Center ROLAC, Ali bin Ftais Al-Marri. Those questions were raised after Le Point said that Al-Marri has relatively long list of expensive properties across Europe that are difficult to be explained in relativity to his official income. In February 2018, Le Point published a catastrophic investigation for the image of the Attorney General. He, the gentleman of the petromonarchy, found himself entangled in a case of ill-gotten gains. Qatar's lauded rule of law and anti-corruption center, ROLAC, has come under heavy scrutiny after it emerged that its Geneva headquarter is owned by a Swiss company itself, secretly owned by its chairman and Qatar's Attorney General, Dr. Ali bin Fayez Al Marri. According to journalist Emmanuel Razavi, author of Qatar's Forbidden Truths, who worked for several years in the Emirate, how could a senior civil servant with no family fortune acquire so many assets in Switzerland and France? Qatar's mission to Geneva confirms that these are second homes, not diplomatic buildings. What does ROLAC do? The Rule of Law and Anti-Corruption Center in Geneva, ROLAC Geneva, is an international center dedicated entirely to the fight against corruption, the preservation of the rule of law, and their study. The chairman of the ROLAC Geneva, Dr. Ali bin Fayez Al Marri, wishes to work effectively and sustainably in the field of his worldwide threat to peace, in close collaboration with the United Nations and in accordance with high standards of quality under his chairmanship. Is the president of ROLAC an exemplary person to manage such organization? For 20 years, he has been in control of the Public Prosecution and Supreme Judiciary Council. He was president of the committees that outlined the laws of these departments in Qatar, customizing the laws to fit his agenda. United Nations report in 2014 by Special Rapporteur on Independence of Judges and Lawyers in Qatar had mentioned 100 points of shortcomings and concerns on how the law is exercised in the country. The Special Rapporteur was also particularly concerned to hear allegations about the complicity and prosecution services in the fabrication of facts or tampering of evidence in certain cases. Highlights on ROLAC. Organization chaired by an Attorney General who has control over public prosecution and Supreme Judiciary Council in Qatar and failed to maintain a fair and independent legal system in Qatar. ROLAC, managed by a politically influent person like the Attorney General, is not an organization that is free of any conflict. ROLAC office in Qatar is empty and vacant. No employees, no representative, just a signboard accumulating dust. United Nations Special Rapporteur report in 2014 clearly indicates the standard of the law in Qatar that has been under the auspice of the Attorney General, who claims to be the protector of rights and fighter of corruption. The report clearly indicates that the effort of the Attorney General in Qatar to protect and serve the public is at a similar level to Third World. ROLAC Board of Trustees are retiree of previous positions, such as district attorneys, judges, ex-presidents, etc., all of which are inactive and do not respond to any emails or calls. All of you have left a firm imprint in the commitment to the rule of law, which will be remembered endlessly. Quote by Qatar's Attorney General on ROLAC website. Anyone who is righteous in this world will leave a firm imprint in the commitment of the rule of law, and anyone who is unrighteous will stain those imprints. But not for long, as stain goes away, with time revealing the imprint inscribed in its place. Quote by opposers of injustice.